Hello everyone, this is BSc second year class. So today we are going to discuss one of the important theorem in this chapter, that is sandwich theorem. The sandwich is the name of the scientist. So he introduced the theorem, that's why the name of the theorem is sandwich theorem. So write down the statement of the sandwich theorem. Sandwich theorem. Statement of the theorem is, if ALP and CN are the three sequences such that if AN sequence BN and sequence CN be the three sequences such that first AN is less than or equal to BN, is less than or equal to CN. That is the nth term of the sequence AN is less than or equal to nth term of the sequence BN is less than or equal to the nth term of CN for all N belongs to set of natural numbers. And second condition is given that limit of AN is equal to limit of CN is equal to L, then we have to prove that then limit of BN is also L. So that we have to prove. So understand the statement of the theorem. If AN, BN, CN be the three sequences such that the nth term of the sequence AN is less than or equal to nth term of the sequence BN is less than or equal to nth term of the sequence CN. That is, the sequence BN is lies in between these two sequences. What that sequence is? AN and CN. Limit of, it is given that in the second condition, limit of AN is equal to limit of CN is equal to L. That is, the limit of both sequences AN and CN is equal to L. Then we have to prove that limit of BN is also equal to L. Now prove. Let epsilon greater than 0 be given, where epsilon is a small positive real number, and also given that limit of BN is equal to L is equal to limit of CN. That is, the sequence AN and CN both converges to limit point L. So from this we can write, so there exists M1, M2 belongs to set of natural numbers such that AN minus L is less than epsilon for all N greater than or equal to M1, and CN minus L is less than epsilon for all N greater than or equal to M1. So we can write from this as L minus epsilon less than AN less than N plus epsilon for all N greater than or equal to M1, and L minus epsilon less than CN is less than L plus epsilon for all N greater than or equal to M2. Now consider small m is equal to maximum of M1 comma M2. We are also given that AN is less than or equal to AN is less than or equal to BN is less than or equal to CN. AN is less than or equal to BN is less than or equal to CN. So from this we can write L minus epsilon less than AN less than or equal to BN less than or equal to CN is less than N plus epsilon for all N greater than or equal to M, where N is a maximum number of M1 and M2. That is the larger number between M1 and M2. So from this we can write L minus epsilon less than or equal to a less than or equal to l plus epsilon for all n greater than or equal to m.
So this is the definition, sorry, BL. So this is the definition of a convergent sequence BL.
So from this we can write BN minus L is less than epsilon for all n greater than or equal to m. So from this we can write limit of the sequence BN is equal to L as the proof. So this is the sandwich theorem.
Now this theorem is used to solve some examples. Now I am going to give you one example, depends on this theorem. Show that the sequence
example depends on the sandwich theorem. Show that the sequence BN is equal to 1 by n plus 1 square plus 1 by n plus 2 square plus dot 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 plus 1 by n plus n, that is 2n square, where BN is the nth term of the sequence is this, converges to 0. 1 or just to the real number 0, that we have to prove.
Now consider the sequence BN. So BN is
proof. So the given BN is equal to 1 by n plus 1 whole square plus 1 by n plus 2 whole square and plus 1 by 2n square.
So from this we can write
1 by n by 2n whole square is less than or equal to this sequence 1 by n plus 1 whole square plus 1 by n plus 2 whole square and so on 1 by n plus n, that is 1 by 2n square is less than or equal to n by n plus 1 whole square.
So from this we can write like this. So this is the sequence we have. Now this is, consider this sequence is AL and this sequence is CL. And both these sequences converge to 0. Therefore, by sandwich theorem, this sequence BN is converges to 0. Now let
AL is equal to N by 2N square, which is equal to N by 4N square, which is equal to 1 by 4N. And this sequence converges to 0. And let Cn is equal to n by n plus 1 whole square.
So this sequence is also converges to 0. Now we have to check the limits of this an and Cn.
So limit n tending to infinity an is equal to limit n tending to infinity, an is what? This 1 by 4n, and it is equal to 0. Now limit of the sequence here, limit n tending to infinity n by n plus 1 whole square is equal to limit n tending to infinity n divided by, take n square common, 1 plus 1 by n whole square. So n will get cancelled.
Now if you put limit n equal to infinity, then this becomes 0. From this we can write
limit of an is equal to limit of cn is equal to 0, and an is less than or equal to bn is less than or equal to cn. So by sandwich theorem that we have discussed, by sandwich theorem limit of BN is equal to 0. That is the limit of the given sequence BN is equal to 0. Now another example depends on the sandwich theorem. show that the sequence, show that the sequence BN is equal to one divided by n square root, n square plus 1 plus 1 divided by n square root, n square plus 2 plus power of 1 by n square root, n square plus n.
Now this is the nth term of the sequence, and if we put n is equal to 1, then we can calculate the first term of the sequence. If we put n equal to 2, then we can calculate the second term of the sequence, and so on. Now this is the nth term of the sequence. Now we have to show that this sequence converges to 0.
Converges to 1. This sequence converges to
1 with the help of the sandwich theorem
that we have discussed.
Now consider the sequence BN. BN is given as 2.
BN is equal to 1 by n square root n square plus 1 plus 1 by n square square root n square plus 2 and so on n square plus n.
This is the nth term of the sequence. Now consider the sequence
n divided by n square plus n is less than or equal to bn is less than or equal to n divided by n square plus 1.
Now we consider these two sequences. This sequence is generated by the last nth term of the sequence, and this sequence is generated by the first term of the sequence. So this can be written as, if we put n square common, now let
the sequence an is equal to n by n square root n square plus n, and the sequence cn is equal to n by n square root n square plus 1.
Now we have to check what are the limits of the sequence an and cn.
Now limit of n tending to infinity, an is equal to limit n tending to infinity, the given sequence an is this n square plus n, is equal to limit n tending to infinity n, take n square outside, n into square root 1 plus 1 by n. Now if you put limit, then it becomes 1.
Now the limit of the sequence limit n tending to infinity cn is equal to limit n tending to infinity, the given sequence cn is n divided by n square root n square plus 1. Now take n square common in the square root and it goes outside by n.
So this becomes limit n tending to infinity n divided by, take n common, 1 plus 1 by n square.
N get cancelled. If you put limit n tending n equal to infinity, then this is 1 plus infinity and it is equal to 1. So an is less than or equal to bn is less than or equal to cn. Bn is the given sequence and an and cn are the two sequences. So the limit is 1. And
limit of an is equal to limit of cn is equal to 1.
Then
by sandwich theorem, limit of bn is equal to 1.
So this is the criteria to use the statement of the sandwich theorem to solve some examples, and it is very important. So many times this question is asked, theorem as well as example on the theorem in your examination. So keep in mind and prepare it well. So today's lecture I am going to stop over here. Thank you.